can't just shut things down when they don't like it anymore. Mr. Harper, by suspending Parliament and thus undermining our ability to hold the government accountable for their actions in our name, has made it clear to every single one of us what he really thinks of democracy.
Canada is at war. And when we are at war, it's important that the House of Commons be able to convene to discuss such a fundamental issue in all of its aspects. I would like you to reflect on the words of those advocating for strong action in the face of the greatest global challenge we face, climate change. Nous avons une urgence d'agir et après les discussions à Copenhague, le Canada doit présenter les cibles pour les réductions des émissions de gaz à effet de serre et notre programme pour les accomplir et nous devons le faire avant le 31 janvier. Mais avec les portes fermées à la chambre de la Chambre des communes, les députés représentant la majorité des Canadiens et Canadiennes qui appuient les actions fortes concernant les changements climatiques, nous ne pouvons pas agir.
When a prime minister is facing a vote of non-confidence, you do not want Parliament shut down. When Parliament has asked for a Prime Minister to deliver documents and he has failed to do so. You have said very clearly across the country in demonstrations everywhere that you want limits placed on the prorogation power of the Prime Minister. I am here to tell you that my party will work in Parliament to do just that.
They did not bother to come up with a believable excuse is they did not think we'd care. They did not think Canadians would notice. And they were prepared to dismiss Canadians passionate about democracy as the chattering class. Well, listen to us chatter now, Mr. Harper! That chattering you hear is Canadians talking to each other. And Canadians talking to each other whose voices rise up. Those voices rise up and they form one cry and it will not be silenced. That cry forms in the word democracy, and we do not allow democracy to be shut down.